from the lectures and from me especially, but I'm sorry, you should suffer again around 20 minutes maybe. I will try. This is the next one will be project implementation. Okay, then we are not, from other point, we are not limited and we continue longer. In my presentation, I'd like to present knowledge management in regulatory bodies. It was a lot of questions about this, and I tried to show how the knowledge management can be implemented in the regulatory body and what is specific of knowledge management in the regulatory body. Now, not everybody from you here is really familiar with regulatory body, and that's why I'd like to start with very general things to indicate what does it mean regulatory body from point of view of the mission. First of all, it's normally independent government authority. And that my question is now coming to you, that when a nuclear power plant is operating, is operated by somebody entering the plant, who is responsible for safety of this nuclear power plant? Who can answer the question? Please.
Operator.
Operator. Very good answer. I think this is a very good done, because many people are saying the responsibility for the safety of nuclear power plants is with the regulatory body. This is not right. Regulatory body is looking for fulfillment regulations which are established by the government for operating of different facilities. And in fact, regulatory body mission cover three main areas. Reactors, it's commercial reactors, nuclear facilities, and whatever, and then research design and used for different purposes. Of course, main facilities here, nuclear power plants. Then, but not in all countries, they exist. It means that sometimes it's research reactors and whatever. Because at the present, in the world, we have around, I don't remember exactly the figure, a little bit less than 500 reactors around the world. Then the next question, which country has the most number of research reactors?
Research.
No. Nuclear power plants.
Russia.
Nuclear power plants. Nuclear power plants, United States. Research reactors, Russia. Then next area of regular material. Materials in medical, industrial, academic setting, whatever, transportation and other produce of fuel, all this area also covered by a regulatory body. And the third area, waste. It's in transportation, storage, disposal, and other things like this. Then the regulatory body is responsible for regulating all these activities. They are not responsible for doing activities, but they are responsible for regulating all these activities. And in this respect, we think and we should care about the knowledgeable regulatory functions which should allow people to be on the safe sides in the country. The strong regulatory body, it's a guarantee that all regulations issued and they are properly, I think, fulfilled by a different organization. And for example, I was involved in the development of regulatory documents in Kazakhstan. Kazakhstan has no nuclear power plants at the present. They had, but now it's closed. And it's a country with mining facilities and other things. And it's not so great in the nuclear other areas. But I was really impressed how many organization should get the license from regulatory body in order to perform their functions. New 1,000. Because this organization Some doing medical, somebody doing some industrial testing, somebody doing the fuel and whatever. Even in this country, without nuclear power plants, the number of the organization which should be licensed this much. Generally, I will not read all these things, but knowledge management can increase regulatory functions performance. This is the important things, and that's why we are talking about regulatory management in here. Knowledge management is very, regulatory body is very specific. They don't have a special equipment. Very often it's a, I can say, paperwork organization observing regulations, computer codes, investigation, whatever. And then that's why knowledgeable individuals ensure the effectiveness of regulatory body. Then by this statement, one of the main focus of regulatory body, competence of regulatory staff. And this is extremely important, that it is a hot issue in many countries. This is five elements of regulatory program. This picture adopted from NRC regulatory program. Then support of decisions. Big regulatory body have research activities, advisory activities, and so on and so on. Then main, regulations and guidance. One area, license decommissioning, certification, licensing of decommissioning and certification and whatever. Operational experience, all regulatory body collecting organizational performance in their particular country and around the world. And oversight, inspection, performance assessment, enforcement, and so on and so on. All these functions need knowledge. And knowledge which accumulated in performing these functions will be accumulated in this particular process and will be transferred through, I can say, research activities and between the between the boxes which are indicated here. It means that the knowledge transfer and reuse of knowledge, accumulating of knowledge, very important. Through this operational experience, event assessment, generic issues, the international experience coming. It means that communication and community of practice with other regulatory bodies, these are key issues for regulatory body if they'd like to be on the top of the state of the art in the world. Climate challenges. Very often they are very similar. I will not again to make all this reading, all the bullets, but we already discussed it in other organization. I don't think that there is some kind of the specific issues. Again, the competence, personal issue, the workforce demographics, it's a key issue here. One of the disadvantages for regulatory body, normally regulatory body body requires a good competent staff, but the salaries of the people who are working under the government very often much less than the people working in the private sector, at nuclear power plant when they or in some commercial facilities or whatever. But nevertheless, this is a reality, and we need to compete with this. I'm coming to the key point in the understanding of the competence of regulatory body. This is taken from the safety report series 79, Managing Regulatory Body Competence, issued in 2013 by International Atomic Energy. And the figure indicates some kind of the area of the competences which are needed to run nuclear power plants. And these four boxes, they are related to human resource or human assets and human capabilities. First of all, when you are running nuclear power plant, you need a competence related to legal, regulatory, and organizational basis. What does that mean? Legal basis in the country and around the world. Regulatory policies and approaches, regulations, management system, and whatever. Definitely you need technical discipline competences, basic science, technology, applying science, and whatever, depending on the activities in your country. But it's not enough. You need a competence related to regulatory body practice, how to make review, assessment, authorization, inspection, and whatever. All procedure in place, and people should know how to do it. Personal and behavioral competence, analytical thinking, personal effectiveness, communication, teamwork, managerial leadership competences, safety culture. It means that if you're going very closely to this and think about this, this is a really very great requirements for the staff in the regulatory body. And if we will consider the new regulatory body, new come a country, then we will see that many countries may face the problem, because they have a problem to hire and to find, to place the proper level people and regulatory body. But again, from the point of view of the safety of the society, this is the key people, because these people who are obtaining and keeping all these competences, they will be responsible in the country for compliance with regulatory requirements. This is the examples of embedded knowledge and KM in regulatory staff. Policies, management directive and procedures, guidance document, and whatever different things, on-job training, records, files, after-action review. All of these elements, they include knowledge. It means that knowledge is standard or natural part of the regulatory body activities. Then we are also coming to very important point, which I already addressed in my lecture number 2, but nevertheless I'd like to repeat it again. When I was talking about competences a few slides before, I was talking about human resources. And these four boxes, they are presented here. Legal knowledge, technical discipline, regulatory policies, and behavioral competence. But it's not enough to perform the regulatory functions. Another components which should be in place from knowledge point of view, these are structural resources. For legal regulatory knowledge management, it's term of references, requirements, code, regulations, and means if we are talking here about tacit knowledge, it's a people, knowledgeable people. Here we are talking about explicit knowledge, because this knowledge should be embedded in the regulatory body documents. For legal documents, knowledge and technical discipline, technical documents, data, and many other resources, IT support, databases, and whatever. Knowledge regulatory practice, internal guidelines, procedure, records, report, review, audits, lesson learned, and so on and so. Personal behavior, code of conduct, documents, training material, assessment, all this area, it's a tacit knowledge which should be in place in regulatory body. And finally, regulatory body is a body which is communicating a lot. And then we are going to relationship resources. And this is the external regulatory resources, legal knowledge from external organization, technical resources taken, TCO communication, community of practice in the area, external sources using international code, and so on. Then this gives them the very broad and complete picture of the knowledge needed to run nuclear power plant. And this is combination, saying by our language, explicit and tacit knowledge. Very often people considering this area, sometimes they are considering this, but resource matrix integrated everything. Then if it's a place, we can say here, not about competence of the people, we can say observing this matrix competence of the regulatory body. Only combination of all these elements will give effectiveness of regulatory body. And this is a key, and this knowledge matrix was, regulatory knowledge resource matrix was introduced a few years ago and implemented in one of the regulatory body successfully. I was part of this team. Then chain model for regulator. Knowledge management. What, again, this idea that knowledge management can provide impact of activities, performance, and whatever. On knowledge level, we are talking about finding, developing, creating, transferring, sharing, and whatever. Then all the things, they are working in order to improve knowledge resources in organization. As I was mentioned, human structural relationship. Then we are coming to all this knowledge available in organization coming to the services. If it's properly designed, then we are going to regulating, inspecting, licensing, and whatever. It's regulatory functions. Proper done regulatory functions will have impact on citizen, nation, industry, international, community, and so on and so on. Then we see immediately how the knowledge management through knowledge management or competence of organization can impact on the services and have a general impact on society. Simple, but nevertheless, it's quite clear. That's why we need a knowledge management, and knowledge management can great contribution, especially in regulatory body, on the performing the regulatory functions. If you can have any questions, you can interrupt me and ask. Standard, ISO 9001:2015. It's not related to regulatory body. It's related to general standard on the management. But nevertheless, in 2015 revision of this standard, organizational knowledge was introduced. I expected that will be addressed before, but because it was not mentioned, I decided to put slide because tomorrow we are finishing, and I'd like that you will know about this. Then I think the organization shall determine the knowledge necessary for the operation of its processes and to achieve conformity of products and services. And what I showed you before, from my point of view, it's compliant with requirements of its standard. But again, you will take this reference, and I recommend that later on you will read this standard. And now all organization which should be qualified by ISO 9001 should have a certification that they compliance with 2015 version. Then we are coming to the picture which I showed you on second day. You was fresh, probably not understand it fully. Now I will repeat again from the point of view of regulatory body. And then now you understand in details what does it mean resource matrix. The first step, this is a organizational knowledge management process. It could be applied for a regulator, who could be applied for other organization, but nevertheless, it's recommended way how to make it sustainable. First of all, we analyze knowledge needs. If we organize knowledge needs, it means that we have a knowledge needs analysis, audit, as we discussed a few minutes ago, and on this way, we are talking about the resources needed to perform regulatory functions. Then, of course, there is some kind of the policy, KM strategy, including action plan, develop strategy, action plan, implement action plan, review, and use the new knowledge which should be embedded in the different regulatory processes. And again, this picture was shown on Tuesday, and that I'd like to indicate that it's equally available to regulatory body. And as well as this picture, This picture also was shown, but now I made a little bit different, some kind of changes, which I think specific for regulatory body. When we are talking about regulatory body, we are talking about different functions: authorization, inspection, licensing, and whatever. We need each of these processes can be called business process. Each process need some special knowledge or competence of the organization in terms of the reference resource matrix which I mentioned. It's a human assets, structural, behavior, whatever. All this combination should be in place. When we are going to implement the some kind of the process, implement action plan, for example, authorization, we identify knowledge needs. We cannot do authorization without this, we need staff in place, procedure in place, some experience should be observed, and so on and so on. Then we are coming to identification of knowledge resources, and finally we are coming to the knowledge resource matrix. Each process owner, person responsible for authorization or for collecting operational experience, he should say, in order to make this function, I need two persons with this experience, this competence should be placed, I need a procedure, I need some database, I need a computer in order to get it, and so on. So all these things, they are in knowledge resource matrix. If it's proper reviewed, and we can say, well, unfortunately, we cannot do this process properly. We can do it bad, or we cannot do it at all. Then we need to go to elimination of knowledge gaps through the special procedure. We can buy knowledge, we can buy person, we can hire a person, we can buy computer, whatever necessary to buy, but proper knowledge resource matrix and resources here should be in place. If they are in place, we are implementing a regulatory process, authorization, inspection, or whatever. Then we are going to some kind of assessment of the knowledge after this, performance and assessment. Because we could be wrong defining here. Maybe we not took in consideration some kind of activities, or maybe it was not properly assessment done and whatever. Then I think we can repeat this if necessary. But nevertheless, after process is done, then we can, I can say, share the knowledge, if it's new knowledge came, and store and retrieve or reuse this knowledge in another processes if it's applicable. For example, inspection can provide knowledge to operational experience, or operational experience can provide feedback for authorization and inspection, and so on and so on. This is how the knowledge management can be implemented on the level of the process, regulatory process, in the regulatory body. I will not read this, time is running, but you will read it later on. There are some requirements on organizational level. There are requirements on the departmental level in site of regulatory body. There are requirements on the individual level, what the people should do. Practically all regulatory staff considered as a knowledge workers. And in fact, it's like this, because all of them dealing with knowledge. What is important here? Also, an example of one of the regulatory body, I think these groups of the people were defined. Experts, the people who are working in the regulatory body and who doing job, everyday job, and what this group also should aware about the knowledge. Special knowledge workers, these people who are responsible in organization for knowledge procedure. Capture knowledge, acquisition of knowledge, defining knowledge, IT people who are taking databases and whatever. And in regulatory body is recommended to have a knowledge manager who will coordinate all this activity. Knowledge manager will work with the knowledge workers. Normally they are in one team. It's this supervisor and their staff. But knowledge manager will work with all department, and each department in this slide has a liaison group, and each one representative from department will be closely work with the knowledge manager and his staff in performing their own knowledge management functions. And on the top, management leaders or leader who will have full responsibility and regulatory body for knowledge management, its sponsor. Of course, main activities will be done by knowledge manager and knowledge workers, but nevertheless, this person is extremely important. What is important to stress here? This person and his staff, they are not capable to do real work with knowledge. They are not technicians or not professionals. They are helping by developing on proper infrastructure, experts and representative of department run knowledge management properly and defining the cross-cutting activities within regulatory body. By the way, it's also applied to any other organization. Knowledge management leadership, extremely important. For leadership, it's what we expect it from the leaders in organization, in regulatory body, and in our organization. Vision, knowledge management vision, and guiding principles. If it's done on top level, as we see, policy exists and so on, this, I can say, good. Clear, sound, and motivating knowledge policy. What we are looking for in any organization and regulatory body especially. And then under this, role model, appraisal system, processes, space, and so on and so on. I will try to finish soon, but nevertheless, one more important thing. This is a knowledge management along the lifeline of employment. This organization, and time to time people coming, spending some time in organization and leaving. This is standard. We cannot stay in organization forever. What a knowledge management, I think, role is here. First of all, experts onboarding. They should be trained properly and put on the board. Then innovation and creativity. We're creating the expert. Knowledge management in projects and in processes. He will be involved. Then later on, he is getting older, and he is subject of the knowledge loss risk assessment. Later on, it's knowledge debriefing, and unfortunately, he is going for pension. You see, few minutes, life is gone. But if we consider the life of NPP more than 100 years, this is a short time we see, but it's reality. He, after some time, taking responsibility of the personal knowledge. And after some, he taking as a senior staff, KM as a leadership responsibility. And practically each person should go in, or is going in similar way, taking the young, be just on the board and going to the knowledge debriefing. Is it set? Set. But it's real life. We cannot stay forever. And again, in regulatory body, it's extremely important to obtain all necessary information, to consider this way, and to accumulate all knowledge which generated by the person for continuation of their regulatory functions. Another slide, which is extremely important for newcomer countries' regulatory body. In new country, we are talking about capacity building. What does it mean, capacity building? Capacity building, this is a building of the abilities of organization to perform functions through human resource development, knowledge management, competence framework, young talent program, infrastructure development. And sometimes it's created and related to education and training program. If we consider the knowledge resource matrix, which I prepared, presented you a few minutes ago, then all these resources coming for improvement of knowledge resource matrix, as was explained. And knowledge resource matrix, it's enable to perform properly regulatory core processes and regulatory functions. The simple as it is. Then, of course, organizational structure, legal framework, safety standards, management system. But this is a key person, and the capacity building is aiming to, we can present it differently, of course, but nevertheless, capacity building in some countries, they are leading to create competence of organization in order to ensure these functions. Some examples. 5 minutes. You can stop me if you're tired. FANR, knowledge management in United Arab Emirates. It's very challenging to be here because the ladies are very beautiful there and dressed very specially. This is how the frame looks like, the framework for United Arab Emirates. You see, very similar what I told, I will not read it step by step, but nevertheless, I think it's done, they are doing well, knowledge management is going on. What the key issue, challenge in this regulatory body? Half staff of the regulatory body, external Western experts. Country is small, and small, young. Young from the point of view of nuclear experience. And in order, but construction of Baraka nuclear power plants is going on. They need expertise to monitor nuclear power plant construction, issue license, make inspection, and whatever that. They hired around 50-60% of experts who are doing the technical work and who are leading the regulatory activities. And other administrative, financial, whatever, they are in charge of Emirates. The main problem in this regulatory body, how to transfer knowledge from experienced Western experts to Emirates. This is the main problem, and the methodology which I explained was applied here successfully, and they have a knowledge management system. Of course, it's, I simplified a little bit, but nevertheless, mainly as it was presented.
I have a question. Can I ask you?
Yes, please.
Do you have a challenge with national culture during implementing
this? I worked in this regulatory body as an external consultant for 2 years. They are very pleased to have us, and I enjoyed staying in this country. I never had any problems. Climate is good. Water always warm to swim after the office. And travel is not so, I think, long. It's 6-7 hours in business class. Looks not so bad. Next example, NRC Knowledge Center. There, it's a screenshot from the internet. And again, here you can see what the main function of this. Collaborate, capture and share knowledge, and build organizational memory. This is another country. This is another background. They have plenty of the specialists. But again, the issue of knowledge management is here. You see, use virtual community of practice, value to the agency, it means NRC, value to the individuals, and whatever. It means that knowledge center support, again, main regulatory functions. Of course, the challenges in United Arab Emirates and NRC completely different. New, young regulatory body, and regulatory body, which probably 100 years old, or I don't remember how much, well, something close to this, this long history and whatever. Another example, Hungarian Atomic Energy Authority. This I will not again explain all these activities, it's not necessary, but what they are doing special database and this database have some kind of the requirements here: robust hardware, robust digitalizing capacity, multi-language thesaur, effective search, different users, reliable software to feed the system, and whatever. This database, like example, that this IT solution supporting activities at Hungarian Atomic Energy Authority. This is name of the regulatory. It's also not really young from point of view of the regulatory functions, because they have nuclear power plants for many years. They are even looking for decommissioning. It means that the regulatory body is well established. But nevertheless, knowledge management can definitely improve their efficiency. Then Nuclear Energy Regulatory Agency in Indonesia, like example, the main task for regulatory body is organizational learning and increasing competence of the regulatory body in respect of all these issues which I already addressed. This is the repositories, the decision-making tools, active knowledge transfer, and definitely they are looking on the organizational learning as a value to organization. It's very short, and just to show you the, again, knowledge management elements, they are here, and they can be used to increase knowledge management. You can read some best practices and lesson learned in regulatory activities. I already out of my time. You can read it later. But for sure, knowledge management can significantly improve performance of regulatory body, and implementation of knowledge management has a special features in implementing. This is the end of my presentation. If you have any questions, I think it's a little bit fast, but nevertheless, I hope you understand regulatory activities and approach. For me, the most important that you will understand that in order to perform regulatory functions, we need organizational competences, the competence which combination of the human, explicit tacit knowledge, their competences and competences in term of the regulations, databases, and what important, the structural, its communication with other world, international atomic energy, other regulations, other regulatory bodies, community of practice, expert in the country, expert outside of the country. Then if it will be done, with help of knowledge management, then the regulatory body will be successful. Thank you.